Well, hello again, and this time we are on Mull's main town, the principal town of Mull, which is Tobermory, famous for its brightly painted buildings, its distillery, which is just behind us, and a few other places as well, a few other things as well. And this is, of course, now a cruise destination. There's no cruise line with us today, but lots of cruises now come here. So you're not allowed to come to Mull. I think it's in the tourist guide that unless you take a picture of all these colourful buildings on the harbour fronts, and that's exactly what we're going to do today. So it's a beautiful day. The sun is out. It's been out all day. It's absolutely glorious here on Mull, which is unusual because, to be fair, it normally rains more than it sunshines. So to have a day like today is exceptional and very, very lucky. So what we're going to do today is, rather than just take a picture of this, I could put my 15 to 30 wide-angle lens on and just boomf, capture as much as that in one shot as I want. But what I'm going to do today is we're going to do panorama. So we're going to use the camera to pan it round to take all of the photographs, and then afterwards we'll stitch them together and see what we can get. Now, to do that, there's a few things you need to do to start before you set up. First of all, tripod. Tripod needs to be absolutely level. Now, your tripod will have, well, most tripods have, a small spirit level, a little bubble on the plate. So the thing to do is to set up your legs in such a way that that bubble is absolutely bob in the middle and doesn't move from there. And that means that this level of your tripod is absolutely flat. Above that, I have a head that locks. So my head is locked into the vertical position. It's a natural click for it. So I know it's vertical. And on the head as well, there is another spirit level that once again shows me that that bubble is absolutely level. So I've got two bubbles that are lined up, which is great. Now, the last thing, of course, is camera goes on top, and then I need to frame it. Now, the tricky thing with panoramas is if you're pointing down, you will point down through the whole image. So my tip is to try and use the tripod, move the tripod legs up and down a touch so that you get the camera exactly where you want it. Now, as you can see, that is spinning around quite freely. My head locks and allows it to spin. So the ball head is absolutely locked, and the other little lever allows the camera to spin quite nicely around. So the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to take a photograph of the first building. This is going to be completely manual, so I'm not going to use any auto exposure, because it's really important when you take a panorama that you use a consistent exposure throughout the image. If you're using automatic settings and the camera's making decisions, it may use a different exposure from one side to the other side, and when you come to put them together afterwards, that might not work in quite the same way. So the first image we're going to do is over here. I'm going to just click that away. That's on manual, and that is what have I taken there? That's f10, and that's a 50th of a second. I'm going to check that on my histogram. That looks pretty good. I'm going to swing around to the other side, and I'm going to take another picture of that side. And it's exactly the same settings, and the histogram looks pretty good as well. I always use the histogram for this, particularly in bright weather. You can't always get a great representation of what's happening using the LCD screen. So I think we're ready to take our panorama. So we're going to focus over there on the first building. Now, before I take the first picture, here's a little tip. I'm going to stick my hand in front of the image and click my hand. Now, that tells me when I'm looking at all the photographs in my Lightroom gallery later, when I see the two hands, the images between those hands are my panorama, rather than trying to work out which ones are and which ones are, and maybe getting the wrong one in at the end and the first one that I took. I know that the images between the hands are my panorama. So let's take the first picture. There we go. First picture taken. Now I'm going to move the camera around now, but I'm going to move it so that it overlaps just one third. So I'm going to move it. In this case, I've got a pink building over there. You probably can't see that. I'm going to move it to the edge of that pink building, take it again. This time I'm looking, and I'm going to move it to the edge of that building. I want a good overlap, because when you stitch it together, you want a nice degree of overlap. So there we go. That's that one taken. Go to the next one. Past the fishing boats. And I'll take it out to sea as well, just to see what that looks like. There we go. There's all my pictures taken. And then once again, to finish, the hand. So there's our panorama. It's now in the camera. What we need to do is go to Lightroom, and we need to get that processed. So there we go. It's a nice long image that shows the whole of shows the whole of Tobermory, all the beautiful buildings, the boats in the harbour, and it's all correctly exposed, and that looks quite nice. I mean, the thing is about these panoramas, there's a lot of detail in them. There's obviously six or seven pictures that make up this one image, so it is a big file, it's a big image. If you want to print it, you are going to get a fantastic amount of detail in that image. If you have enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up. Leave a comment down below, and of course don't forget to hit that button over there somewhere and subscribe. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.